been using the flash because this is what it looks like without it. I'm in my bedroom and it's 5 p.m. So I've been meaning to post a Christmas Day, my personal Christmas Day video. I couldn't post it because it just didn't happen. I didn't do Christmas yet. Today's December 30th. I couldn't do my regular Christmas Eve, Christmas Day activities on the 24th and 25th because it started snowing a lot. It was very snowy and then there was high winds still from the storm. The storm was on the 23rd. We still had high winds, so it was impossible for me to just go have a walk outside. It would not have been fun. It would have been pretty much impossible to film. And it was really cold, so I was like, okay, I'll do it on the 26th. And then on the 26th, I started coming down with something, and I've been pretty much cooped up in here, in bed, since then. I have not left my house since the 22nd. I've only gone out to go up and down my stairs here, to go up to take a bath and come down. I desperately want to go out for a walk, but it's been snowing every day with wind, and it's kind of difficult to walk in a snowstorm, especially if you have a cold or the flu and you're feeling tired. So I've been trapped inside this whole time, but now I've decided, you know what, I'm gonna turn on my camera and I'm gonna try to do something. Dark even in here. This bulb just went out and I'm all out of light bulbs. And yeah, the closest store is very, very far from me and it would be a big effort to go there. So, this is what you get. So tired, coughing, just feel like I wanted to sleep all day, which is basically what I've been doing. I tried to use all the medicine at my disposal, so basically drinking a lot of water. I also drink electrolytes every day. I drink bone broth, which tastes like, but I put flavoring in it. One of the Christmas gifts that I received, the elderberry homemade syrup that Celestine gave me, came in really handy. I've been drinking it every morning and night and I feel like it's been helping. I feel like since I started taking it, my symptoms are a little less and I'm starting to get better. I'm almost all out of it. I think I'm gonna drink the last of it now. I asked my friend if she had more of it, she's gonna check, and if not, I'm just gonna ask her, how do you make it? Where do you get the berries? How is it made? I'm gonna try to make my own because I think this is really good. And yes, they do sell it, but it's quite expensive. I've ordered some on Amazon. And the thing that's happening with Amazon right now is that they're so backed up. During Christmas, even if you had Prime, the Prime fast delivery was 3 weeks later. You cannot have same day delivery or next day delivery yet on Amazon, even if you have Amazon Prime. I think now they're down to a week later or 8 or 10 days. I've ordered some stuff and I'm not gonna get it until January 7, 8, 9, 10. I've ordered some elderberry syrup. I mean, not as natural as this one because it's not homemade, but the closest version that I could get, which I think is made in Quebec. I could tell by the packaging because it was all in French. Also, I've been scouring my medicine cabinet. Cash Jordan. I've been watching too many Cash Jordan videos. I'm all about medicine cabinets and sing sprayers now. If you haven't checked out his channel, check it out. He will make you laugh. And it'll be like walking around New York City with a friend. I found these. I had these in the back corner of the fridge. It's balsam fir gum capsules. This is a traditional herbal medicine used to ease respiratory tract infections and inflammation. I've been taking two of these in the morning, two of these at night, and I think it helps. Everything that is for a cold or the lungs comes from trees. I also have this cough syrup or throat syrup. It's called Ponku Seal. This is also all natural, all plant-based. I'm a very big proponent of healing yourself with plants and natural remedies because they work. This is very good as well, so I've been taking this. And I got this Ayurvedic chest balm, kind of Vicks Vapor Rub, but with Ayurvedic natural ingredients. It has turmeric in there, it has eucalyptus, beeswax, Chinese mint. As soon as I put some on my chest, it it cleared my passages. I could breathe finally, so I've been putting that on morning and night. It stinks, but it works. What else I got? I've been taking double dose vitamin C, echinacea, L-lysine. I have a lot of supplements, so I try to do everything I can to eliminate this virus, infection, I don't know what it is. I was supposed to go to Bernie tomorrow for New Year's Eve, but I canceled. I didn't want to bring him whatever I have. He has another friend who's gonna be there, Marie-Claude, so he's not gonna be alone, but yeah, I had to call today and say, hey, I can't make it, and I hate it because I was so looking forward to seeing him again and having a nice New Year's Eve party with them. I wanted to bring some food, and I was gonna bring some crema. It's kind of a champagne alternative. It's a little more affordable. It's some sort of sparkling wine. I'm not going to. First of all, I didn't want to bring him my illness. Also, I don't have the energy to have a New Year's Eve party with other people. At least if I'm doing something here, I can stop when I'm tired. I can have a nap if I need to. And I'm at home. So I'm gonna try to make this video. I'm gonna do some tonight and continue tomorrow. Hopefully I can go out and take a walk. It's just that I can't really go outside if the wind's gonna be 40 kilometers an hour in my face and it's snowing and it's minus 10. It's not gonna help my condition. What have I been doing? I've been sleeping, eating, trying to watch YouTube videos, writing a couple Christmas cards every day, and I finally wrapped people's gifts. December 30th, finally wrapped your gift, your Christmas gift. And it's super late. I'm gonna take my medicine. So, two of these. This is also a product of Quebec. It's called Sapino. I'm not even sure if this is still in business. I've had this for a long time, but they are still effective. Some people throw out things just because the expiry date has come up. Use your better judgment. A lot of things are still good after the expiry date. You just have to use your better judgment. Drink the last of this, and this tastes really good. The taste is somewhere between blueberry and grape. It's mildly sweet. Very, very nice. There wasn't even any sugar in it or anything. It's just the fruit, the berry. And after I started using all these, I had these coughing spells where you could feel that something was trying to come out. It was more than regular coughing. It was a little strenuous, but that's good because then the bad stuff is trying to come out. That's too bad. If anybody has any, my address is in the description. I would truly appreciate it. I also have something I was using last year. I haven't tried it again yet. It tastes so bad though. This is a product of New Zealand. I've had this problem for a really long time. My nose is always stuffed. I cannot remember the last time I was able to breathe freely through my nose. I always have stuff in there. Every single day, winter, spring, fall, or summer. It never goes away. And it's not particularly dusty where I live. I go outside, I clean, I vacuum. I'm not allergic to my cat. What is it? Last year I bought myself a Navage nasal irrigator machine and I left it in Vancouver because I was using it in Vancouver when I was having these problems. And I should have brought it with me, but it was kind of bulky, so I was like, oh, I'll just buy another one at home and I'll have one in each place because I have a storage locker in Vancouver with a lot of shit. I bought this last year. I used it for a couple weeks in the winter and then I stopped. It's called Rocket Fuel. Yeah, so you can imagine just with the name how good it tastes. It's a 100% natural sinus and respiratory support from the company SaviTouch. Also not sponsored. I paid for it. The ingredients are Manuka honey, deionized water, menthol crystals, apple cider vinegar, eucalyptus oil, peppermint oil, lemon oil, and aloe vera. So you're basically supposed to shake it well. It becomes quite sludgy. And then you drop a couple drops on your tongue and you swallow it. And I suggest to have a glass of water nearby because the taste is not good. This is used by athletes for some kind of performance enhancement, but I wanted to get it just to clear up my nose. I stopped using it, so apparently it was not that effective, because if it had been that effective, I would have kept using it. I used it every day for at least 2 weeks. They say start with 3 drops and then build up to 10-15. Well, was I supposed to take 10 drops of this? I'm gonna try. I want the stuff to work. This is what it does. I don't know. Is this the elderberry? Is this the balsam fir gum? What is causing this? Something wants to come out. Because I've taken them all together, I don't know which one of the remedies is doing that. I'm not trying to do this for effect, like, this is what is happening naturally. Sorry, disgusting, but real. We're keeping it real on this channel. Are you ready also to finish on the Navage? I've been debating if I should buy another Navage machine. It actually has a battery in it and you put salt water in it. Circulates the salt water from one nostril to the other and it aspirates. You end up with water and gunk in the tank. You pour it out. You're supposed to do that once every day in the morning. And my dad, I have to say my father, lived to be 93 years old with a very advanced lung cancer that he probably started developing in the 50s because of asbestos and all the dust that he inhaled at the hospital when they caught it 10 days before he died. He had a lesion in his lungs that was 4 inches wide. And he was still pretty vigorous. He was still climbing up the roof to do repairs. And he did that every morning. He would dissolve his salt water in a cup and he used a straw and he would just aspirate some of it and it would come out the other way. And I'm like, it must be good for something. He did that every single day. And he lived to be 93, even though he had conditions. I think there must be a lot of good in it. Also, I wish I could just breathe. I wish the gunk would just get out of my nose. I can never breathe. I can never take a deep breath. I don't remember the last time. It was years ago. I've tried so many things and nothing works. Spent so much money on so many things, don't work. But then I'm like, it's $100. And I know you're gonna say, oh, it's only $100 for your help and blah, blah, blah. The thing is, it's not just $100. You have to buy their special salt pods that are made by Navage that are really expensive. And if there is not a new salt pod in the machine, it does not work. If you use an empty salt pod, it does not work. it has to be their salt pots that are super pricey. I know someone on eBay that sells a little gadget, a little device that you can put in. It makes the device think that there's a new salt pot, but I haven't tried it yet. It might work or it might not work. And then you could mix your own saline, because you know saline is really cheap. It's just salt and water. That should be super cheap, but they sell it really expensive. I don't want to be exploited like that by a company just because I want to be healthy. I think health should be accessible to people, and it's kind of evil to try to profit from someone having a health problem, and that's what they do. So basically I decided to try the manual type because obviously it worked for my dad just with a straw and a cup. They have those bottles that you squish, it just goes in one nostril and goes out the next one. That was $20 on Amazon, so I'm gonna try that. If that doesn't work or it's too tricky, I will buy another Navage. I tried to find Black Friday deals. I tried to find promo codes. They don't offer it. There's nothing. I even tried to buy one off eBay. It was $50, but the shipping was $50. It comes back to $100 anyway. But will I have to shell out the $100 again? Maybe, but I'm gonna try the $20 one. Before, I was reading the reviews on Amazon. I spent so much time researching that, but again, I have to wait a week to receive it. Let's try this thing. In my experience, what it did is that it tasted really bad for 5 seconds. You felt kind of something for like a minute or so, and then after that, you're right back to having a stuffy nose. In my opinion, it doesn't work, but maybe I didn't take enough. Do I need 10 drops? I'm gonna start with 5. You see, it's pretty sludgy. Maybe I should rinse this. Got it clear. I have a box of Kleenex at the ready. I can blow my nose 10 times and there's still stuff coming out. So it means that my body is producing it constantly. There's something systemic going on that I need to address. Ready? We're gonna take 5 drops of this. Oh yeah. I mean, it smells like Vicks Vapor Rub. It's not a bad smell, it's just very strong when you put it in your mouth and ingest it. You're not supposed to ingest camphor and eucalyptus and menthol. You're not supposed to take it internally, but I'm ready to do anything. You're supposed to take this internally, but normally you're not supposed to take all that. Or just in very small quantity. You have to do it on the back of the tongue, that's what they say. I did 10 because I'd like it to work. Oh my god. Ooh. That's very strong. It tastes really bad. Whoa. Ugh. Ugh. Oh no, it makes you want to pee. Ooh. And you know, I'm not the delicate type. Like, I am the kind of person who will drink the green stuff that people don't like because it's healthy. I have a lot of acquired taste things that I think taste good. Oh my god. I can't drink. It literally feels like you just freeze burned your tongue. Oh, and now it's cold. You have this cold sensation all down your throat. Going through my nose. I don't know, because that's the thing. My problem is not with the throat itself, it's more with the nose. And whoa. Still, I can still feel it. Very powerful. I don't know, maybe I wasn't using enough before. But yeah, it's not. It's kind of. It kind of gives you nausea. I'm stopping myself from drooling all over myself. You just want to drool. Oh. see how long it lasts?
Ugh.
My god. Ugh. I feel like I'm gonna throw up. Ugh. This is really, really bad. I can feel it all the way to my ears. Hopefully, I hope it's gonna do something. But it's so unpleasant to take that this might be a factor why I might not use it. Ugh. I'm not gonna do this every day of my life, that's for sure. Okay, now I'm gonna apply the balm on my chest. Yeah, I'm not done. And I wanted to take this, but I'm gonna wait until after I eat something.
You can't really tell if it's day or night. Is it raining? On top of the snow. Yes, all you people's gifts are now wrapped, except a few last ones because I ran out of scotch tape. I need one more box and a couple more envelopes. Otherwise, they're all ready to be sent.
And I also wrapped my own gifts. My Christmas gifts from me to me that I haven't unwrapped yet. They're in Santa's bag. Probably gonna unwrap them tomorrow. I'm totally out of fruit ketchup. I love this brand, Retour aux Sources, local brand. Now to eat with my meat pie, with my tourtière. Fruit ketchup is the best. The taste really goes with it because if you eat only meat pie like that, it tastes good, but it's a little dry. You need some kind of sauce, some kind of accompaniment for it, but I'm all out. I guess I could use regular ketchup, but meh. I kept some stuff. This was my dad's fridge, and I kept some stuff that was in it. You know, like pickled stuff that he had. That is probably still good. I know some of it is still good because I tried it. I tasted it. He had some green ketchup. It's called Chow Chow. The red fruit ketchup, it's a lot sweeter than that because it has apricots and peach and tomatoes and red things. This is just green tomato ketchup. It's a little more on the bitter side, on the pickled side. I mean, it can do for today. This keeps for a long time because my dad had that. So this is more than 1 year old. Hey, it's pickled. I mean, it keeps. That's still good. Oh, you know what? When I went to Montreal in November, and you're gonna have these videos all through January, my Montreal vlog series, I went to a coffee shop and they were selling homemade pickles and I got a jar of them. And you know what? I forgot to take them out for my Christmas dinner. I totally forgot about it. The jar stayed in the fridge. I haven't tasted them yet. We're gonna try that. Concombre sucré, sweet pickle. They should call it sweet pickled cucumbers. The translation is so-so. De la ferme Guy Rivet in Rawdon, Quebec. So that's at the southern part of the province. This is how you open a jar. Oh, smells fresh. Smells like cucumber. Try that. They're sweet, but not too sweet. They have the pickled acidity. Very good, very balanced taste. I like it. This will do. Nice. I bought that at a coffee shop on Bélanger. Je l'ai acheté sur la rue Bélanger à Montréal au café Le Fort Breton. That's where I got that. I'm gonna need something to wash off that bad taste, so these pickles are gonna come in handy. I think it's gonna clear my bronchi. My bronchi? Is that what you call it? Les bronches? Bronchi? Bronchi? Bronchi. I don't know, a lot of people in Quebec would know that word, so don't get on my case. Do you know what bronchi is in French? This lamp used to be in my bedroom. I've put it on here because it's so dark. I totally do not like this thing. It needs to be there. These bulbs are too bright. Maybe if I got bulbs that were softer, but I got 5 of them. But even then, it's lighting up the ceiling. The light is not directed where it should go. It's directed upwards. Here it's again an Amazon thing. This one doesn't work. This one doesn't work. And it's not the bulb. Oh, that bulb worked. So maybe I could use it in the bathroom. So I put this for now. See how weak it is? I need to charge it again. And here, there was also another one. So I'm gonna need to have an electrician come in January and take a look at this one, and this one. So at least I have some kind of adequate lighting when I'm cooking and doing the dishes. Online? And then eventually I would go to Home Depot or something and get a proper fixture for here. Maybe an elongated shape. I'll choose one and I'll ask the same electrician to take that off. Bring that connection here so we can have proper lighting with that switch. An electrician nowadays, I think they charge $125 an hour before tax, before material. So I can't do all of that at the same time. It's gonna be a little bit every month. Oh, and I got this new charging station. I just received it. I used to just drop all my phones in this plate. And then I had this thing plugged in the wall and all the cables would just go there. This is still a lot of cables, but at least it looks a little more organized. It takes a lot less space. It's made of bamboo and it is a charging station. So you have all the ports here. You just plug everything in there and then you can put your phones or your iPads or whatever device in the stand, and you can take out the dividers if you have something that is larger than a phone. You could take this one out if you had something that was bigger. It's very practical. I just got that from Amazon. Recommend it. So this one has a different one. It's not a USB-C. What is this? Anyways, I'll put it on the screen. See, it has one flat side, but I have the charger for it as well. Charge it, put it on the charge. The thing, it stays there. Woo! Saved up a lot of space. I don't know what I'm gonna put here now. Maybe my bullet journal could move from the table to here. And maybe I could move some of these pens as well that I use in my bullet journal. I'll have to do a whole reorganization of the house maybe. This is a gold journal. Watching Downey live, a really cool YouTuber from Vancouver who travels by train and boat and all kinds of cool modes of transportation.
System of the UK with over 2,000 miles of navigable waterways.
Maybe I could drink some of that pickle juice. You think it would help my throat?
Actually, really good.
I couldn't have asked for a more perfect first day. Wales, you're incredible.
Now, I'm going to make myself a cup of thyme tea, which is basically an infusion made of thyme leaves, and it tastes horrible, but this is what I resort to when everything else fails. I've been sneezing, I've been coughing, and I'm still sick, it's still not coming out. I'm gonna make some thyme tea. Another thing you can do also, you can take whole cumin seeds and boil them in water for 20 minutes. This also tastes kind of weird, but I wouldn't call it horrible. I might do both, because I want this bullshit to leave my body ASAP. This is a traditional remedy from India. It's been used for centuries. I'm gonna add a little bit of turmeric and black pepper. More of the pickle juice? I'll try anything at this point.
Merry Christmas!
Something's gonna end up working. Have this thyme from Serbia. In Serbian, it's called Majkina Dučica. And I have this nettle tea, also from Serbia. I think I'm gonna combine them for maximum effect. Something's gotta give. I need a break. Is this thing? I'm gonna make it really strong. I think these are in bags.
Tanya,
look at the color of this. Yes, I will drink it all. I put a lot more than you're supposed to put. I made it strong. I want it to work. Do you realize that I have ingested not one, not two, three different things that taste absolutely horrible in the course of 2 hours? So one of them better work. It's not bad in the other way. And after I'm drinking these two, I will drink them until the last drop. I will also take another cup of bone broth. Oh, met toutes les gens d'un côté. So I'm gonna keep drinking my two nasty tasting drinks. And then I'll get some rest and I'll talk to you tomorrow.
Once we finally get it turned around in front of the crowd, there are some very friendly boaters who noticed we're new here and they wanted to greet us. You see, narrow boats aren't just for holidays.
One gone, one to go.
Lives aboard their boat, but also locals who can come use the towpath to walk or jog and get away from it all. I mean, you have to admit, this is amazing.
Hey, give me a break. The taste.
Might just be one of my most interesting adventures yet. This country is one of the most beautiful countries I've ever seen. But the fact that you travel it by boat just doubles. It's a little oasis in town. And now it's time for dinner. Ah, here's a pub right on the side of the canal. Let's stop here. Onwards we go to the next pub for dinner. They weren't serving food anymore, which worries me about the next one. Okay, we've checked the map and there doesn't seem to be any more canal side restaurants ahead of us.
It's getting harder to finish. So now every time I have a bite of food, I have to take three big sips. Otherwise, I'll never be done. Let's go for five, otherwise we'll be here all night. I think it's starting to work.
The shortest canal in the network.
Five more sips. Almost done. I can see the bottom of the mug. Hey, ready? Thank you.